next on the Backcountry Vagabond. Backcountry living, fresh, clean.
Woof, light her up.
They have ruined it for me, ruined it.
This is your Backcountry Vagabond, Greg Sydenham, inviting you to join me for a backcountry adventure.
Good afternoon. It is day 18. The major thing that's happening in camp right now is we have a power shortage. I've got like 6 or 7 devices that I need to power using my 4-volt battery. My poor little Goal Zero small size solar panel won't charge it as much as I need. So it's been progressively getting lower and lower and lower. And last night it finally died and I didn't get my phone charged completely. So we have to remember a couple of things. What are the shots I want? What specifically do I need? Because I've got 3 or 4 drone shots I really desperately want to get. I've got 1 full battery right now. Controller battery is going to be getting due to be charged. The phone always is going down. And these batteries only last like 8 or 9 minutes. I've got to be real careful about how I'm planning my shot so that I'm able to get exactly what I want. Went fishing today. Again, still have that spinner on. Haven't taken it off, but they were not really hitting it that hard today. I did catch 4 fish. Caught a brook trout today, first time in several days. I'm just not catching very many anymore. Not that I caught a lot already earlier this year, but I did catch that 1 14-inch. But 2 years ago, I had a big brook trout bonanza. And I still want that day to happen again. I think you need to be up here just as the snow melts so you're able to catch the big ones. But I don't think I'm going to find out. I'm too old to return. No, that's not true. I'm too old to hike up here. We are running low on media, especially with that stupid little 4K son of a gun that just keeps eating media. But hopefully it looks gorgeous. Here's hoping. Can't charge anything because it didn't get sunny until about 2 hours ago. It kept looking like it was going to rain, but it never did. So because we can't charge anything today, I'm going to pretty much wrap this up. I've got fire pretty much laid. All I gotta do is splash a little gasoline and woof, light her up. Then I'll go ahead and cook dinner and we'll call it an early evening. I almost wish I had 1 rain day, just 1, but if wishes were horses. All right, until later, I'm the Backcountry Vagabond. Later, dudes. So the big news of the day is that the streak is broken. There's a father-son in their own inflatable kayak. They have ruined it for me, ruined it. But before I saw them, I went out and I caught a couple of fish. This is what's for dinner tonight. Look at that. That's 2 gorgeous rainbows. Big, gorgeous fish. I'm not even sure I'm going to have a whole meal. I may just have fried fish tonight. It's the first fish I've had this year that's had mature spawn eggs. That is a hunk of meat. I'll tell you what. That's a big damn fish. Okay, fish number 2, another big, what's that got to be, 1 foot long, maybe a little longer, 13 inches if you're stretching, and I am, this is 5 inches, baby. they're going to town on these wigglers, dude, just full of them. Looks like maybe a dragonfly in there, I don't know. You may think that it is unsightly for me to gut and clean my fish on camera, but I personally believe that everybody should understand how we get things. And this is just how we get things. Look at that. That is 2 big, fine chunks of meat for the pot tonight. Oh yeah, backcountry living. Fresh, clean, and free. I think it's just about time for me to have a swim. Afternoon is just starting to fade. I'd say it's about 2:30, 3 o'clock right now. Maybe what I like to do first is have a little bit of the fresh. Success! Yeah, that'll do her. I'm gonna go ahead and take a dive, clean my shirt, wash my hair. Maybe I should get a shave too. Then I'm gonna maybe take a nap. I'll see you later. It's a beautiful evening. My streak is over. Two gentlemen came through, a father and a son. I would love for more people to enjoy this. Just not when I'm here, please. Please, please, please. Although I really admire what that dad is doing. Here's a kid between 11 and 15 out on a camping trip, hiking trip with his dad on an inflatable raft 20 miles back into the wilderness. They're just out there fishing, being guys, being father and son. I miss those days. I miss those days. And I'm glad people are still doing it. So I am not going to begrudge them the fact that they've ruined this trip for me. Because they represent what I think is most needed in this nation. More people that get out with their families. More people that go out and enjoy the wilderness. More people that see that it's not just about city life, that there's... I don't know how to express it. That's the problem, I guess. I don't know how to express how wonderful it is. You know, you watch all these survivor shows, and don't get me wrong, Les Stroud is the man. But they're all pretty damn serious, you know? Well, they're surviving. They could possibly die. But they're not having fun. And for me, this is fun. It's more than the solitude. It's more than the fishing. It's more than even this. You know, this takes up a good chunk of my time. I'm occupied mentally almost the entire day. I'm thinking about stuff. I'm rehearsing lines. I'm running over lyrics that I don't get right very well. Wound her up to 110, my speedometer. Wound it up to 110, my speedometer said I'd hit top end. My foot was glued like lead to the floor. That's all there is, and there ain't no more. Cut it. Cut. It's just such an enjoyable time. I've been here 2.5 weeks. In the last 2 weeks, I've seen these two guys. I sent them to a good campground a ways away because, you know, Vagabond needs his privacy for his nude sunbathing. But they're out on a peninsula. They're at the camp where I lost my boat, because that's the nicest camp I've seen so far, but bad memories for me. I think about looking up and seeing that boat out of the lake and thinking, a boat, that's your boat. Oh my God, you have to go get that now. It happened, boom, 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 boom. And you may not be prepared for how you react in some of these situations, and sometimes you're going to fail. But just being out here, just getting here is the challenge, is the story, is the adventure. Your failures are part of the adventure. Now, granted, I really wish I had tied my boat up, dumbass, but I didn't, and I got really lucky. That's got to be the shallowest part of the lake, and I didn't even know it. I just got lucky. Somebody's looking out for me. My mother's prayers. Thank you, Mother. Thank you so very much. What a day fishing. And I'll tell you what, I woke up this morning, I walked down to my boat landing, I threw two casts and I hooked a 12-inch rainbow.
But that's real.
Ate it for breakfast. And then I went fishing, and right behind my island on the upwind side or the northeast side, I hooked into two beautiful rainbows, one about 14 inches long and one about 16 and a half inches long. Gorgeous fish. Good fights. I wasn't fishing more than 20 minutes in my boat because I was planning on going all the way down to the island if I needed to catch a couple of fish. And I probably should have let the bigger one go. I got it second. I should have let it go and hoped for a later one that's going to be smaller, but I got a little greedy. There was so much damn meat. I am fish drunk right now. I didn't even add a dehydrated meal to it. No stewed fish, just fried fish. There's just so much of it. Big shouldered female, that long one was. Still had spawn in her, which sort of surprises me because I would have thought that they'd be on their beds. And I caught her in deep water. But I don't know. It's It's got to be the water temperature. Water's probably, I don't know, upper 50s, maybe 60 degrees.
Holy shit!
Comfortable, you know, once you're numb. I thought that getting out to the island would mean I wouldn't have to see any people. But what happens? Somebody else shows up with a bigger boat, a better boat than me, and blows me out of the water. Well, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up. I think my fire's slowly dying. My cup of chamomile tea looks like it's steaming hot. Oh, yeah, that's warm. That's lovely. Oh, okay, well, regardless, good night. Good night. To each, I wish a good night. Please. But I'm getting full cast, because that's all the line I have left on my reel.